CK, are we all good? All right, good afternoon. Thank you for joining us today. Today, we end the spring session of the General Assembly in stunning failure by the supermajority Democrats who control our legislature. The Democrats in the General Assembly have failed to pass a balanced budget. They have failed to pass reforms to protect our property taxpayers. They have failed to pass reforms on our pension system. They have failed to pass reforms to grow our economy and create more high-paying jobs. They have failed to pass reforms on our political system through term limits. Stunning failure again. Speaker Madigan's Democrats have controlled our General Assembly for more than 30 years. Speaker Madigan's Democrats have controlled spending in our state government for more than 30 years. Under the Democrats' control, we have the highest deficits, the highest debt, the highest unfunded pensions of any state in America. Under Speaker Madigan's Democrats, we have the highest unemployment rate of any state in America. Under Speaker Madigan's Democrats, we have the highest property taxes of any state in America. Under Democratic control, we lead the nation in people leaving the great state of Illinois. We have to change direction. We must fundamentally reform our government so it works for the people again. And we have got to stop spending money that we don't have. We have got to stop the deficit spending. Now. We have to stop it now. The budget that the Democrats passed is $7.5 billion out of balance. To pay for that budget would require our income tax to increase to 5.5%, a massive income tax hike to pay for this unbalanced budget. The Democrats know that the people of Illinois, the small business owners, the job creators of Illinois, don't want a massive tax hike. So they're not being honest. They're not talking about the tax hike. They just want to appropriate the spending, let our unpaid bills pile up, and then, after the general election in November, put in the massive income tax hike. That is their intent. President Cullerton was pretty candid about it, that they don't want to take any reform votes now, don't want to take any difficult votes now, wait until after the general election. That is wrong. We have tried in good faith to work with the Democrats for the past year through our working groups on a bipartisan basis to come up with reforms so we can get a truly balanced budget, grow our economy, and protect our taxpayers. We were making significant progress in recent months. Significant progress. Members of both political parties in private were negotiating in good faith to come up with compromises on spending levels, on new revenues, and on reforms to grow our economy and protect our taxpayers. Speaker Madigan became concerned in recent weeks that too much progress was being made. He was not ready to embrace reform, inserted himself in the process, slow-walked the budget groups, the working groups, and then President Cullerton on Friday gave us the word that the working groups could continue to function. That would be fine, and they'll continue to talk, but really no votes on these issues were going to be taken until after the general election. That was his word to us on Friday. At this point, it is essential that we give stability and confidence to our teachers in Illinois, to our school children in Illinois, and to the recipients of government services, our university system, our healthcare system, our correction system, our public safety system. We have got to have stability. These services must be continued to be provided. They cannot be held hostage for this unbalanced budget that will force a massive tax hike on the people of Illinois next winter. We can't hold our schools hostage for this massive tax hike. We can't hold our government services hostage for this massive tax hike. And President Cullerton was candid on Friday that they've been holding up operations funding to put pressure on our administration. They want pressure in our correction system. They want pressure in our healthcare system. They want pressure on our university system. That is wrong. It's not fair. We can't allow it. That's the reason we have introduced two bills. One, to fully fund our K-12 school system and our early childhood education system now, right now, with more money, 100% of the foundation level, K-12, as well as a hold harmless $105 million, so no school district will get less money under the current funding formula that the Democrats put in place in 2003. So Chicago will not get less money. No school district will get less money under the current funding formula that the Democrats put in 2003. And our schools can open on time and we can give them the confidence and dependability they need, stability that the teachers deserve in Illinois, the school system, the parents and the students deserve. We've also sponsored a bill today, this morning, to make sure that essential government services, our university system, our healthcare system, our correction system, our government operations that our citizens depend on can continue to function through January, which is the time frame that President Cullerton indicated would be the time frame that they'd be willing to negotiate a truly balanced budget and a broad-based compromise. So we are calling on the General Assembly, don't wait. Don't hold our schools hostage. Don't hold our government operations hostage. Don't hold the people of Illinois hostage. Pass these two bills now to bring stability to our state while we continue to negotiate in good faith on reforms through the working groups and we get through this crisis. Hopefully we can come to a broad compromise before the general elections. We're going to try to do that. We will try every day, 7 days a week. But President Cullerton has indicated that really the time will ultimately come down to next winter after the election. So we've got to take action now to get us through to next winter. Here's the time. Economic growth is the key to balanced budgets. Growing our economy is essential to having balanced budgets. If we don't grow our economy, we will never have truly balanced budgets. Our debt is too big. Our unfunded pensions are too big. Our property taxes are too high. We need reforms to grow the economy. And if we had just merely grown the great state of Illinois at the nation's average, and we should be growing way above the nation's average, but if we have been growing at the nation's average over the last 15 years, we would not have a deficit today. We would not have need any tax hikes. We would have not any deficit because of economic growth. We would not have needed the 2011 tax hike. We would not have any unpaid bills. And we would have well over $10 billion more in the state treasury to fund our schools and our human services. Economic growth is the key, and our entire turnaround agenda is focused on value for taxpayers and, most importantly, economic growth, creating more jobs, higher incomes, more competitiveness for the Illinois economy so we can all prosper and have a higher quality of life for the people of Illinois. That's what we've got to have. It's clear we've been going in the wrong direction for too many years, and our agenda is about turning that around, and that will lead to balanced budgets in the long run. Family incomes on average have declined over the last 17 years. We are going in the wrong direction, and struggling families are hurting. Their property taxes are too high. They don't have enough job opportunities. The key to rising family incomes is a healthy, competitive economy, creating multiple jobs for people to choose from. That's what raises family incomes. And some have said, well, it hurts the middle class, or it's a race to the bottom to have these types of reforms. I hear that very frequently. The tragedy is, look at the other states that have much more pro-growth, pro-turnaround agenda items in their policy. Texas, Tennessee, Indiana. They are growing faster than us, and factory workers in Texas which many people say, well, that's an anti-worker state, that's a pro-business state. Factory workers in Texas make more money than factory workers in Illinois. Factory workers in Indiana, when you adjust for the cost of living, make more than here in Illinois. We've got to change, and economic growth raises everybody's incomes. The special interest groups that like the status quo, they're spinning things that are just not true. Economy and create more high-paying jobs. They have failed to pass reforms on our political system through term limits. Stunning failure, again. CK, are we all good? All right, good afternoon. Thank you for joining us today. Today, we end the spring session. Speaker Madigan's Democrats have controlled our General Assembly for more than 30 years. Speaker Madigan's Democrats have controlled spending in our state government for more than 30 years. Balanced budget. They have failed to pass reforms to protect our property taxpayers. They have failed to pass reforms on our pension system. They have failed to pass reforms to grow our General Assembly. In stunning failure by the supermajority Democrats who control our legislature. The Democrats in the General Assembly have failed to pass a